our crack team of monster builders will have to beat the heat, the clock, and maybe even each other to turn this dull domicile into a rainforest hacienda. The homeowners have agreed to hand over their keys to the cocksure caballero of home renovation, Steve Watson.
Working these guys like government mules.
He's got 5 men and 5 days to pull off this exotic overhaul.
When this comes on TV, it's gonna hurt.
Okay. It's good to be the host of Monster House.
Our house was plain and simple. It was safe and normal. It was nice and sweet. But we all agreed we could use a change. And then something happened that was very strange. 'Cause a van showed up, all our stuff went flying. And my mom was crying till the job was done. Now it's a monster house. It's a monster house. It's a monster house. And we all just love it. It's a monster house.
Meet the Mangies, Alessandro and Leticia, Alex and Leo, Noel and Linda, a full house with fond feelings for their native Nicaragua. Mom and Dad want a hacienda, a traditional house in the country, to bring a Central American feel to their new home in the suburbs.
I think an hacienda will remind us of our younger days. To give our kids this opportunity to see this because they haven't seen this.
Cuando éramos niños, porque tenemos una hacienda en Nicaragua.
But traditional isn't exactly what the kids have in mind.
We want the monster house!
They've called in the right guy.
How's it going? I'm dying to see the place.
Steve's specialty is putting some monster into middle-of-the-road abodes.
There you can go.
Yes.
That can go. That makes me happy.
The Mangies have given him free rein over all design and construction decisions. And once he takes over, all they'll know is what they can see from the 2 motorhomes parked out front. Steve calls in his design team to help put some jalapeno into this hacienda. Architect Todd Erlinson, illustrator Craig Rizzo, and Latin American design expert Oscar Albuerne.
So tell us about the hacienda.
The Mangie family is a great family. They want a hacienda theme. They're from Nicaragua. How can we take that and incorporate those things from their native Nicaragua and just make it just monster?
There's so much we can bring into it, you know? I mean, we got Mayan culture, we got rainforest, really kind of put a whole twist on it.
We got this utility room that they're begging us to work on. First of all, I want to open it up. I want to tear this thing apart. I want to rip this entire
Get
ceiling
a little
down.
Height.
Yeah.
How are you going to tie it to the backyard, right? You got a covered porch here. It would be good to kind of have some dialogue between those two spaces.
Sledgehammer.
Yeah, just open up a big opening right on this side.
Well, I'd like to incorporate one of these big Mayan idol heads. I want that thing to lift up and then rise up, and it's always looking down on you. And that could be part of your access to the outside. What if that was your bar under there? What if you had your bar that connected the inside and the outside?
We'll also have a passage that'll be created by sliding out past the wall. Now we can enter from the side. And you got 2 bars. You got one for the inside and one for the outside.
Even better, the only thing better than 1 bar is 2. What about this other wall on the other side?
I can see that wall, just all Mayan blocks.
I love that. The ruins, the big stones going all the way up to the crest of the ceiling.
We're going to have a post and beam construction with a little deck on top that can give them back some of their storage we're taking away by opening up that ceiling again.
This is going to be our storage loft up top. Just because we can, just because I want to, we're gonna have this big, crazy-ass monster metal tree that's gonna go out to the center of the room. We gotta build him a big bitchin' barbecue. Got to. Big industrial flame-throwing barbecue.
Here's the plan. The utility room will be gutted. The new space will feature a hacienda-style post and beam loft. The east wall will become a Mayan temple with a rainforest tree made out of metal. The back wall will be torn out and replaced with a Mayan sun god. Its base will be a bar that slides out to allow access to the outside. The bar will open onto the patio, which will get jungle trees and corrugated tin siding, topped off with a built-in outdoor grill.
It's gonna be unlike any other hacienda out there.
The plans are in place, and it's time to bring on the builders. Gerhardt Pet Shower, all-around carpenter and Brooklyn bruiser. Marcus Arnold, finishing carpenter. Mike Petralia, race car fabricator and welder. Ed Lingard, licensed general contractor. Dave Robinson, licensed electrical contractor, professor at LA Trade Tech. The challenge, complete the entire job by midnight Friday. The prize, tools from Makita and ESAB worth over $3,000. The Manjis are up and out, just as Steve pulls in to pick up the keys.
This is the key to the house.
Thank you.
He starts the week by giving them a little taste of what they're in for.
Let's back that truck up a little bit.
They'll have to wait until Saturday to see what else Steve has in store. It's time for our team to take over.
Okay, guys, listen up. This week, we're gonna work on the utility room and this outdoor patio area. What we're gonna do for our family is we're gonna give them a Hacienda theme. We're gonna monsterize it. Over here, we're gonna build a loft in a Hacienda-style post and beam construction. We have a raised platform. You've got all the beams. We're gonna have a storage loft on the top of this. Here, we're gonna build this big, badass metal tree. What you're looking at here is a Mayan godhead. That's where we're gonna put this area right there. That lives up on a track to expose the bar. This bar needs to slide out. The bar's gonna rest on the shoulder of this Mayan god, and it's gonna open up to the patio area. This is the other side of the bar once we open this wall out. People can have access to both sides. Out here, we're gonna cover the walls, the roof, and the ceiling with corrugated tin. See these posts right here? By the end of the week, I want those to be big, bitchin' concrete trees. One more thing. I want a grill right here. Alex, the father, likes to barbecue. This is important to the family. They like to hang out by the pool and barbecue together, and so I think it's a nice finishing touch right there. You ready to get to work?
Yep.
Oh, yeah. I say let's get to work.
Before any building can begin, the utility room needs to be cleared and gutted, down to the bare studs. A 70s-style bar that belonged to the previous homeowner definitely needs to go. Marcus is happy to oblige. This up-and-coming carpenter has been kicked out of bars. Now he gets to kick into one. Dave shares a little trick of the trade.
Kick it harder.
Ed and Mike finish putting this disco dinosaur out of its misery. Next to go, a wall of mirrors that went out of style with leisure suits.
Nobody's superstitious here.
These guys know how to kick it. They do demolition, that's for sure.
Electrician Dave does a quick safety check on the outlets.
Okay, that's dead. Okay, this is all dead also.
The electrical's terrible in here, so we're gonna have to gut all the walls just to see what's going on.
But we'll just redo it and they'll have a nice place when we're done. All right, this wall can be torn down now.
Inside the walls, they find a fire waiting to happen.
That is about as dangerous as it gets. I'm shocked this place hasn't burnt down.
This little guy, he learned firsthand about the bad wiring. He experienced what it's like to get 120 volts scorching through his body.
It's a problem no one predicted, and it could take Dave the better part of the week to get done. The ceiling also has to be demolished. But a glance into the sweltering attic reveals a ton of junk abandoned by the past owner.
About 130 degrees up there.
Any volunteers?
I'm not going to.
As a service to the rest of this crew, it'd only be fitting that the bigger guys get up in there and hand the stuff down.
Hey, it's not the biggest guy that gets to go in the smallest spaces, you know?
So who steps up to take the job that nobody wants?
Everybody got scared, man. They were all afraid to come up here.
I could not resist the temptations to go snooping through someone's personal belongings.
I don't know. Probably too hot to put these blue slacks on.
Anything valuable?
Oh, yeah. I got a lifetime supply of slippers.
Oh, that's mine.
Little me. man's junk is another man's treasure.
With the attic finally cleared, Marcus starts sawing out the ceiling.
Watch, 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 watch. Heads up.
Ed wants to see how much ceiling he can cut away while still standing on it.
How about a ladder?
Get her out. Get her out. There you go.
We're right on schedule. These guys are working hard, and they got all this demo done, but now I've got to get them focused for the next step of the build.
All right, guys. How you doing? How you feeling?
How you doing?
Well, it's going to be a long week. Want to see who's going to take on what responsibility?
So far, electrician Dave is the only one with a clear job to do.
We have the electrical to reroute, and as you can see, we've got flex lines up here that we got to figure out what to do with those.
I'm kind of concerned about getting a ceiling.
To keep the rest of the team focused and moving, Steve appoints a foreman, Ed. He's got 26 years experience and is the team's only licensed general contractor.
Ed's going to be basically our trench leader, who is going to be making sure that you guys are on target, you hit your marks, and you get this stuff done.
But these boys are used to being their own boss.
Ed might be the eldest senior member. With seniority comes experience, usually.
Ed is a GC. You know, he has the credentials. He doesn't seem to be afraid to tell people what's on his mind. I like that.
You know, I could follow. No big deal.
The new foreman lays down an ambitious goal.
Be done Friday by 3 o'clock.
I would love to be done Friday at 3 o'clock. And we got to remember that people do have to live here. They do have a lot of kids. When we walk out of here on Friday, it's a dwelling for a family. So all that stuff has to be up to par.
The builders go back to work. In the RV, the Manjis already have their feet up and shoes off.
Right now, my mom's giving Noelle a pedicure.
It's not much better getting a pedicure for my mom, having my hands moisturized, chilling in the RV.
Any concerns they may have had this morning have vanished.
They could do whatever they want to the house. I'm not worried at all.
The demolition is nearly done, but the crew is feeling the heat. Today, the temperature topped out at 100 degrees. Tomorrow, it's supposed to get even hotter. Confident that they're ahead of the game, the crew beats the heat and beats feet. It's only 7 a.m., and the heat is on already.
I got a digital thermometer. I just brought it. We can just set it up and keep track of the temperature today to see what we're actually working in.
It's going to be up to 100 again. Water, we've got some towels on ice back there. Keep yourself cooled down. It's not worth a heat stroke on this thing, you know.
Today is going to be a lot of grunt work, including framing out the loft and drywalling the entire room. The
main thing is I want to make sure that we're drywalled by tomorrow. By tomorrow midday, and then we can start working on some of the more complicated stuff.
They also need to figure out a way to make the sliding bar slide. Foreman Ed takes on this challenge and brings in Marcus to do the blueprints.
We need the bar to slide out so they can get behind the bar and serve drinks. If somebody's in here, let's say a Mayan warrior, and he doesn't want you in there, he can push the bar forward and squash you between the outside bar and the inside bar.
The outside wall right here.
I wouldn't say it's really difficult. It's just figuring out how to make the bar operable because it's a moving bar. I've been in a lot of bars that seemed like they were moving.
Their plan is to put the bar on rolling casters. It will be attached to a guide pole hidden inside the wall. But first, there's the little matter of clearing a path to the patio. All it takes is a portable saw, a hammer, and an ex-linebacker.
Put some muscle into it.
Goodbye, back wall. Hello, lumber. Right behind, a whole lot of conduit for rewiring the entire room. Dave gets right to work roughing in the wires. Ed and Marcus frame out a new front wall. Outside, Gerhardt settles into some serious goofing off.
Does the camera love me?
The last thing this crew needs is more hot air.
Here I am, Hollywood.
We're at 91 here on the patio. Out front, it's 99.
As the heat index rises, so does our foreman's frustration with the builder from Brooklyn.
Woo!
Hi, guys. Big monster balls.
Too much talk entirely, not enough work. I don't know what the word is to describe it, but there's something going on in his head that's undescribable.
Hey, dude, quit hogging the camera, man. We got
work to do. You've been standing here for a long freaking time, dude. Let's go. Get it. Oh, you're sitting down again, huh?
You know, there was a guy, Eddie, in Florida, man. I shouldn't say it. I shouldn't say.
That's good fun, right?
Look, see, Eddie's he's messing with me. Should I smack him now or later?
I've been pretty mellow so far on this, but it's getting to the point where to get anything done, we're gonna have to start riding everybody.
You really don't want to cut those nails,
no,
huh?
No, okay. Just put it in.
It's not gonna be uptight.
I've been standing around talking about it too much.
They're both carpenters and they don't seem to, you know, like one another.
Finally, something snaps.
Yep. Easy.
Come on.
Come on, guys.
Okay. Now you really want to hit?
Lighten up.
Want full contact, baby?
I'll knock your up, boy. Huh?
Come on, guys.
The fight is over, but the heat hasn't gone away.
Come on, this ain't getting this anywhere. Spring? Dead?
No. No, it's bleeding. The heat got to me.
Steve steps in to cool things down with popsicles.
What's going on? I hear all this stuff going on out here. I came out here to bring you guys some popsicles, and I hear you guys are slapping each other around. What's happening?
Well, you know how when kids are playing, one will hit the other one too hard, and then the other one has to hit him back
to
make up
for
it.
What, did he hit you too hard? Wise guy, right? You know, it's only Tuesday. It's only the second day. What's going on?
I know.
Well, you're next tomorrow.
The foreman and the fool call a truce.
All right, I forgive you.
But it doesn't take long before another builder starts rubbing Ed the wrong way.
When they frame a building or a ship or an airplane that they want to burn on screen, they actually make it out of metal. Make it out of wood because you want it to burn.
I think Mike's not working enough and he's talking a little too much.
By noon, the mercury has hit 101. The only one that the heat doesn't seem to bother is Little Miss Manji.
Right here is the kitchen where my dad mostly cooks. This is the bathroom. There's enough room for one person, just for one. This is the refrigerator. These are little ice cream biscuits or something. We're not worried about all the strangers in the house because we know they're gonna fix it for us and they're gonna make it better.
Back on the job, Motormouth Mike isn't so content.
The way that the tools and equipment are set up in front, I really feel it's pretty much backwards.
Mike's latest monologue falls on deaf ears.
Yeah, should have the power tool cart and the top cart with battery charge and everything. They should be up front.
I think Mike's worrying too much about where the tools are. As far as thinking about rose bushes and location of the tools and stuff, that's pretty ridiculous. You got a job to do.
So far, day two has seen a lot of babble and a little bit of boxing, but not much building. These overheated builders need a cold dose of reality.
What I want to do right now is I want to show you guys something. Maybe this is a little motivational tool. It kind of generally works. Time remaining.
The message seems to sink in. Frustrated with his sluggish teammates, Marcus shifts into high gear, building the raised floor and frame for the loft. It's the height of the afternoon, and the temperature outside is 105.
It's hot out here, man.
Eventually, the heat starts to take its toll on Superboy.
Cool. I got a lot of done.
Anybody else working hard?
I haven't really paid attention.
All right.
Mm-hmm. I'm just trying to get a task and finish it.
Well, you've been doing a great job. I mean, it's 105 degrees today. And that garage has got to be 115.
Steve sees the warning signs of heat exhaustion. So he sends this workhorse of a builder home to chill.
So we'll see you tomorrow?
Yeah, I'll be here bright and early.
All right.
Thanks for your concern.
Their goal for the day was to get the framing up and the drywall done. Neither is even close to finished. As dusk settles in, our weary team heads home, hoping today's fiasco isn't a sign of things to come. It's 7 a.m., and the first builder on site is Marcus.
I'm feeling better today. I think I'm just going to try to pace myself more and not try to go so crazy.
He starts right in where he left off yesterday, framing out the loft. But this morning, he gets some help.
This is a lid for the bench under the window.
That was quick.
After yesterday's turmoil, Steve is anxious to get this team back on track.
How you doing?
Doing good. You all right?
Yep. I'm fine.
One goal that I don't think we're going to make, but I think it's going to be all right, is having this stuff all skinned out and drywalled, insulated by lunch. It's not too bad. I think we'll be all right.
But his pep talk falls flat.
So you guys give yourselves a hand for that so far.
Too many questions remain unanswered.
What's going to happen with that bar? Did we actually arrive on the design?
As far as the mechanical part of the bar, we're not even close to being there yet.
Progress on the bar is being held up by welder Mike, who needs to get the sliding frame finished and moving. Foreman Ed decides it's time to crack the whip.
I'm not going to hold you up. You don't need to worry about waiting on me for it.
Why is it taking so long? The idea is just to do it and hurry and get it done. You can make
I'll
it
get
work.
It handled. I will not
it's
be holding
Mike's
you
job.
Up.
He'll
I'll
take
get
care
it handled.
Of it. You're holding me up, but you don't see me crying about it.
I'm not crying.
Well, get that
I'm
framing
just telling
done so
you.
I can rough it
bitch,
in.
We got
bitch,
a...
bitch, bitch, bitch.
Why doesn't everybody just bump nuts and get back to work?
This isn't doing anybody any good, so let's get back to work.
Did we decide what we were going to do with the bar?
Yes, we've decided how to make the bar move. I will finish the frame on the bar. I'm going back to work.
All right.
See, Eddie, what you did, you pissed him off.
I got everybody Eddie, back to work, didn't I?
You used some psychology, didn't you, man?
Yeah, didn't I you? Used psychology on
man,
it.
Yeah, you must have been a psychology major.
I used reverse psychology. You don't need a major for that.
Anyway, I still think it was a very productive meeting.
Ed may have gotten Mike back on task, but this morning's show of teamwork is nowhere in sight.
Scott, why didn't I think of that earlier, man?
I don't know.
I don't know.
So far, nothing on Monster House has been quick and easy. I noticed tension on the job site. They start bickering like old women and...
Marcus figures that what this team really needs is some positive energy.
Just go in and say a couple of pleasant things to get everybody on the same page.
What are you smiling about?
Smiling about you, hot hip. Nothing, man. I just like the way you work, man.
Yeah, right.
Anything I can help you out?
Yeah, I could use you up there. I got I've had doing something.
Check. I'm right there, bro. Way to keep the ball rolling, dude. You're like, stop being bitchy and just get going, right?
Just as Marcus's morale boosting seems to have lifted the team's spirit, another breath of fresh air blows in. Kelly Van Patter, the Monster House decorator, swings by for a visit.
I heard that yesterday we actually came to blows. A little too much testosterone. Today I've come to bring just a little bit of feminine energy.
Kelly will put the final polish in this radical renovation.
So basically we're just taking the traditional hacienda and set in the middle of a Central American rainforest doing a whole new spin on the monster hacienda.
Cool.
We've got some big, thick vines, but then I also got a lot of silk greenery. I might possibly put a hammock in here, something for the kids to hang out in. All right,
cool.
Ciao.
See you later.
See you guys. Bye. Take care.
Our motif maven goes out, and our Mayan sun god comes in. These pieces are molded out of a special fireproof urethane. After being coated with a hardening agent, they are painted to look like Mayan temple stones.
Taking it inside, and the longer I keep it out here, the more likely someone's gonna see it.
But with the sun god comes a new problem.
This is too big, dude.
That sucks.
The foam panel is too wide. Once it's attached to the frame, there will be barely enough room to get outside.
You're not gonna be able to walk through.
That's what I was talking to you about earlier.
You're like, welcome to the Temple of Doom, right? Welcome to the Temple of Doom. Hold on, let me get you a drink, dude.
Yeah. Man, that screws us up big time.
Mike comes up with a solution.
I'm gonna cut it and make this a very weird shape.
Mike thought of a better way of doing it.
He will cut and re-weld the frame at a 45-degree angle. But this takes valuable time that this team doesn't have.
If I would have thought of this yesterday, it'd already be done. I mean, it would have been done.
The week is now more than half over, and the team is only getting further behind. Determined to keep things moving, Marcus replaces a window that somehow got broken on day one.
Now, our loving family has this beautiful, crystal clear window to gaze through.
Gerhardt starts working on the outdoor grill. Dave is still stringing wires, and Mike and Ed are welding and grinding away at the frame for the bar. But there's one job everyone seems to be avoiding, the drywall. It was supposed to be done yesterday, but so far, not a single piece has been hung. Until this drywall is up, the electrical can't be finished, and the foam pieces can't be mounted.
If they don't get this drywall done and move on to another project by the end of the night, then they're not gonna make this thing. There's not a chance. I wanna get it done for the family. If they don't make it by Friday night at midnight, screw their prizes. Time to get busy, that's what time it is. It's been killing me not to be able to put this piece of drywall up all day.
With Marcus leading the charge, the first sheet finally goes up.
First piece. It's ridiculous.
Out front, Miss Manji is doing a little woodworking of her own.
So what are you doing?
I'm sanding the stick.
It's cool. Well, give me that thing. There you go, check. Is that good enough? Is that good?
Good.
By nightfall, the team has made progress on the drywall. But it's been a long day, and Mike and Gerhardt decide to call it quits. The only builders willing to work late are Ed and Marcus. Day four, the last men out are the first men in.
Me and my amigo here opted to kick out a few extra hours, go the extra mile to finish this build. Some of us wanted to go home.
But before he even gets inside, Ed starts the day off on the wrong foot.
All right there, buddy?
Good morning, America.
Day four, Monster House.
With so much left to get done, they all know that today is do or die.
I'm not gonna say today's gonna be easy. I'm not gonna say it's gonna be short, but I'm just hoping it's gonna go better than it did yesterday.
I feel like we should have had a lot more done than we finished out with.
Steve attempts to light a fire under his struggling foreman.
Whatever you need to do to get it done, to make sure these guys work for you, whatever you need to say or do, then that's up to you and you do that.
You're the trench commander.
Well, it's been like they know I'm the general, but they think they don't work for me.
And I'll make sure that they're clear on that. All right, guys. Okay, listen up.
We're all stuck together. We don't have a choice, and we're committed. And that little kid sitting there waiting for the deadline, and we can't let her down and her brothers. I'm usually pretty nice, but we don't have much time, so, you know, if I have to be, I'm gonna be in. And I can do it. It's just I don't like to get ugly like that.
But I will.
All right, well, let's go. We've got 1 day and 15 hours left and 25 minutes. We've got 3 days worth of work to do in that time. So it's gonna be all balls out, busting, hollering, screaming, yelling, get to work type of day.
Ed's sparring partner, Gerhardt, takes on the still unfinished drywall.
I'm ready, baby.
Ed and Marcus concentrate on getting the guide pole for the bar attached and working. Foreman Ed also keeps an eye on the bigger picture.
The biggest thing is I want to keep Mike, the fabricator, busy all day so he doesn't have time to talk to me.
He assigns Mike the job of fabricating the metal tree. The trunk will be a 3-inch cold steel pipe. Mike's job is to weld on metal supports and branches. Mike pulls out his torch and turns on his mouth.
Ed, show me what you want welded.
Start welding some branches and some vines or whatever it is that's going on there in any direction. It doesn't matter. Just do it.
This is going to be the first monster metal monster metal tree I've ever built. Can't say that three times fast. I wonder if there's a market. You think there's a market for these monster metal honking trees? Oops, my string just fell down. Lost my string. No problem. I'm going to say it like I'm talking to Steve here.
I'm much more accustomed to fabricating very precise machinery.
I'm thinking I'm kind of doing it. Dude, you talk more than anybody on the job.
I'm putting in my work too, all right?
It's hard to get you to do anything. You want to rethink every frickin' step of everything we do.
Hey, Ed, just relax, okay?
Hey, Mike, you gonna take that from Eddie?
He doesn't have to take it from me. He can just leave.
Mike cuts the chatter and concentrates on welding. Things quiet down until Ed realizes he's made a mistake and he needs Mike's help to fix it. The sliding bar needs a stop to keep it from rolling away. The one Ed has attached is too short, so he asks Mike to weld an extra inch of metal to it.
It's not really highly technical, but just do it.
The weld gets done, but the sparks keep flying.
Let's review why I had to weld that on there.
Because I told you to.
But if you had measured this thing correctly in the first place, I wouldn't have had to weld it on there, so don't give me.
Why don't you take a break? Take a break for about an hour. We don't need that kind of.
Well, you know what? You don't have to go off on a power trip, okay?
I'm not on.
We are all in this together.
I'm just trying
to get this
power
trip. Okay.
Oh, you're wasting time, right?
No. I have asked you repeatedly.
You're wasting my time.
I have questioned you
time.
Repeatedly on your design ideas. I try and give you my ideas, you don't listen. You f it up, then I gotta go back and fix it for you. How much more do you want me to fix for you that you're gonna f up? Huh?
Every mistake I make, I want you to come back and fix, okay?
I will.
All right, that's your job.
So when we lose, whose fault is it? Yours.
Yeah.
You're the boss.
Yeah, it is my fault.
I am gonna take a break.
I'm not losing on account of you, I can guarantee
that's,
you
that's
that.
That's
right
sure
now,
you won't.
Pal.
That's right. I think he's a hack, but I still have respect for him because he does his job.
Ed and Mike had a couple of words, but looks like Mike is, you know, getting his work done. That's what's most important right now.
I wouldn't take that garbage from him, man. I would have hit him already.
It's okay.
It's okay? Well, I don't like it.
Bar.
You want me to hit him for you?
No, you already did that.
I'll do it again.
Here, wait.
It's definitely not a happy environment.
It just takes away from the job.
Steve steps in to lend Mike a hand. He quickly realizes that what this welder really needs is a little direction.
Tack weld those, boom, good stuff, a branch. Make it come out like, you know, like this, out, then up, and then you have another small one coming out going over there. And it'll give it that really nice feel, that nice look.
I'm distressing these to make them look like they're, you know, it's a big gnarly tree. Steve finally gave me a really good direction, so now I'm hitting it.
Mike is back on track, but now Marcus is starting to slip.
Building the bar is becoming more and more of an issue. You know, it's a lot of thinking. I'm trying not to second guess somebody. After lunch, I decided I'm gonna break off just to get away from gnarly guy.
He turns his energy to transforming the patio posts.
I'm gonna wrap these posts with this chicken wire.
and then we're gonna stucco over it and make some trees out of it.
After 4 days of low-key toil, Dave has brought this home's high-voltage muddle up to code.
No big deal.
His reward?
I ran out of electrical work to do, so they're forcing me into the drywall trade. And if you don't help us out, he's gonna get us a kick.
Out in the RV, the Manji kids are hacienda dreaming.
Well, I'm thinking in our new monster house, we might have, you know, chickens, roosters.
Some new walls, paint, windows, cows.
Even Mom, whose life seems to be one long pedicure, allows herself to dream.
A big bar, big river, and I think I found a monkey.
Evening arrives, and our team is now in a desperate race with the clock. Marcus has rejoined Ed at the bar in progress, and they finally have it moving. Sort of. Over at the tree, Mike's endless talking has turned into endless welding.
I think that guy was building a docking port for the Challenger to go to the International Space Station.
Once this thing is painted and dressed, it's gonna look great.
But the Mayan walls haven't even been started, and the patio still needs trees, tin siding, and a grill. Friday will be here in no time, and this tired team has only got one day left to pull off a miracle. Friday, the team stumbles in early for their final day on the job.
Whoa, I need some damn coffee.
But before picking up any tools, Mike and Gerhardt pick up some grub.
I like to have my pancake Friday. Breakfast of champions they are.
Out back, workhorse Marcus has little appetite for flapjacks or his teammates.
Sit around, have pancakes, talk this fun with me.
As for our fearless foreman, the week has taken its toll.
It's hard to move right now. No sleep.
You think he's about spent?
Look at him.
His whip cracking has only brought bruised egos.
Let's just say the worker morale is at an all-time low.
And his bar project is still far from finished.
I feel like one cranky bastard today.
Today's first priority is turning the patio posts into tree trunks. The cement they're using normally needs a full day of drying before it can be painted.
So we've got to put this accelerator in with the mud to decrease the drying time, make it dry faster, because we don't have a lot of time to wait for the cement to set up. The original recipe probably came from something military. They didn't have to lay bridges and do all that stuff for the war anymore.
We just need to get it done and get moving.
So you want me to stop talking to the camera? Is that what you're saying?
Just stop talking, period.
All right.
Outside, the Manji kids are curious, and they've cornered Dave.
How many walls did you break down?
That's confidential. I can't tell you that.
How many workers are there?
Can't tell you that. Sorry.
Why can't you tell me anything?
By mid-morning, the trees are drying, the grill is finished, and the tin siding starts to go up. Inside, the bar is finally ready for its Mayan sun god. Reaching this milestone brings a ray of hope. If they can get it up and moving by midnight, victory is theirs. It looks like this tenuous team might actually pull it off.
Here we are. Don't touch, just go, move.
Go.
Okay.
What? Scott just said give a hand with the foam. I'm trying to give a hand. Do you think I'm gonna break it?
Tell them. Yeah.
Hey, a little.
He's got zero respect for me now. You know, to treat me like I'm some monkey. I'm a Neanderthal. I'm gonna break everything I touch.
I don't know why he just has to push my buttons. I don't know why. What did I do to him?
Mike has had enough.
Mike. He looked like he was hurt, bro. I don't know where he's at, man. Mike!
In there, bro.
He might have went to his room.
Sorry, Steve.
Sorry, hold up for a second, man. Hold up.
Okay.
Hold up.
I walked it off him.
Yeah, hold up. Hold up, just hold up. Hold up. Take a deep breath. Take a deep breath.
That's why I took a walk.
Listen to me.
I wouldn't walk so far if I
listen to me. Listen to me. I know the tensions are up in there, and I know that, you know, Ed's getting on your and stuff.
You know, I really think he's just trying to push my buttons. I'm not going to let him do it like he did yesterday.
Bottom line is, it's, you know, you're doing good work. Your welding looks good. That tree is bitching. You know, when you leave here, everything's going to be cool. Mm-hmm. You're doing great work. I mean, seriously, and I appreciate all the work you've done. Thanks. That tree wouldn't be half what it is if it wasn't without you, and all that stuff wouldn't be welded the right way if it wasn't for you.
Thanks. I got something in my shoe.
Back at the house, Ed isn't doing much better.
Dude, you all right? What's up? Tired.
Every time I see Mike or I hear his voice, I just cringe. I feel like going over and unloading on him. I'm pretty burnt out. I don't think we'll make it. I think we lost the day we started.
Just as the team is about to hit bottom, a ray of sunshine shows up.
Our house, it was plain and simple. It was safe and normal. It was nice and sweet. But we all agreed we can use a change. And then something happened that was bad.
Linda, singing the theme song.
High five.
That's rock and roll.
All right.
Get back to work. Yes,
that's right. Could this little songbird be just the cure this troubled team so desperately needs?
I think you guys can do it. I think you guys got what it takes to do it. I think we can knock it out. I think we can walk out of here tonight at midnight with every damn thing finished on this build. Do you guys feel the same way?
Yes.
I'd like to be able to come in here tomorrow with the family and look at it and go, look what we did. Am I right? Am I right, Gerhardt?
You're right, man.
I'm not willing to fail. Sorry. It's not in my vocabulary. Amp it up and let's just elbows and asses, man. Let's just work this thing out and get it done. All right, guys?
The builders set their grudges aside and step on the gas.
Yeah, we'll
be. I think we got everything done and then some. I'm not worried about it.
Marcus and Ed hang the guide track for the sun god. Across the room, the foam stones get carved down to size.
Set it down and come on in.
I got it from here. Thanks, Ed.
Come on, man. Come on.
We're gonna get
this foam in. Look, watch.
They got the track up. They're right on track. You know, I mean, they can pull this thing up.
With only an hour left, the final stone is set in the Mayan temple wall.
That is it.
Now, they just need to get the bar's sun god to rise.
All right.
To make it move up and down, they use an everyday garage door opener. For the first time all week, this team is working in unison.
I don't know if it's just the fear of not making it. I don't know what it is, but right now, they're working together. If they would have worked together like this all week long, this thing would have been done.
But with 10 minutes to go, the sun god still isn't moving.
Right down to the wire.
Let's see what happens when we run it.
If it doesn't work, we're screwed.
I got nothing.
Midnight hits, and the job is nowhere near done.
We got nothing. I got nothing going on. That's it. That's it.
All right.
Basically, we had to call it.
We had to go. I mean, the stuff, you guys are all really good at what you do. You guys all individually did great work this week. As a team, up until the last 3.5-4 hours, didn't work great together. But the last 3.5-4 hours, you guys were rocking, and it was great to see it. So, I mean, I don't know what to say. We just had to call him, so.
Well, I won't say the time's up. Well, it looks good. Wish it was finished.
I wish it was finished. I'd love to see it finished.
Sorry. Yeah. But thanks.
Thank you for putting in a hard week's work.
I'm square out there.
Place is not finished. I have less than 12 hours to move this family back into this house. Before that, I have to get Kelly and her crew in here to trick the place out. So I'm going to call in some of my superstar builders I've worked with in the past, get those guys in here, and I'm going to finish this build.
They step out of the shadows and build furiously into the night. But can even these sleep-deprived superheroes save this hobbled hacienda by noon tomorrow? It's 9 a.m. Saturday, 3 hours until the Manji family moves back in.
The build crew didn't get it done by midnight last night, so I had to bring in my superstar crew. They've been working all night long, and they're still working, and they're all really tired. Kelly and her crew are here, so they're all in there together. I've got a family to move back in here today, and the way it looks right now, we're cutting it close. I'm not sure if I'm gonna get it done. Gang. You guys ready? Let's do this thing.
Okay, come on.
You guys ready to go inside?
Yep.
Let's go check it out.
Shock!
This is so amazing.
What do you think, guys?
Yeah. Oh my God. This is so cool.
Oh, beautiful. Oh my God.
I know you've noticed the Mayan sun god. There's something else we'd like to show you.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
You guys want to go outside?
Yeah.
You've got yourself an indoor bar right here. You can go on out.
It's amazing.
Oh my God, look at that.
This fountain here is from Andre's studio. Uh-huh.
Everything.
Check this thing out.
Wow.
That's a new place.
Great. Are you happy with everything?
Uh-huh. Oh, yes. Very.
Is there anything you would change about what we've done?
Oh, no.
Thank you very much. It's my pleasure.
You did a great job.
Thank you. Their reaction makes the hard week worth all the work, and that's what we're looking for. And the builders may not have succeeded this week, but we came in and finished the job, and it was worth all the hard work because this guy right here and the rest of the family, they're a happy bunch of folks with this new hacienda house. Am I right?
Yep.
Cool.
Until next time, when who knows, the monster may be coming to your house.
Monster house. Very
is no such thing as time. No to-dos and no agenda, only joy and peace of mind on the happy hacienda. Come spend the weekend, stay for a year. You may find what you're seeking is all right here. I hear.